Despite being victorious, Bret Hart's post-match attack on Steve Austin only served to galvanize the fans into fully supporting Stone Cold. And Austin, even in defeat, would only increase his reputation by living up to his word, refusing to surrender in the match. Steve Austin fighting the sharpshooter with everything he has remains an enduring WrestleMania moment in a career filled with them. 4 years later, Austin found himself in a very different position in WWE. Taken out in a heinous attack at the 1999 Survivor Series, Austin would be out for nearly a year before returning at No Mercy in 2000. Austin would first look to exact revenge on those who took him out, Rikishi and Triple H, before setting his sights on regaining the WWE Championship. Stone Cold would then head to the 2001 Royal Rumble, entering at number 27. Before he could enter the ring, he'd again be attacked by Triple H, looking to avenge Austin's interference earlier in the night. Austin was in bad shape, but somehow managed to emerge victorious, securing his opportunity to compete for the WWE Championship at WrestleMania 17. Defending against Austin would be The Rock, Austin's main rival for years. The two legends personify the Attitude Era, and had previously met for the WWE Championship in the main event of WrestleMania 15. That night, Stone Cold managed to defeat the corporate champ to regain the championship. On that same night that Rock captured the WWE Championship at No Way Out 2001, Austin would face Triple H in a three stages of hell match. Each fall would be held under different rules: a standard match, a street fight, and then a steel cage if necessary. While Austin took the early lead in winning the first fall, he'd lose the next two in a heartbreaker to Triple H. The loss shook Austin, who felt the wave of momentum he was riding should have been unstoppable. Heading into WrestleMania, Austin would speak openly about how he didn't just want the win, but that he needed it.
I need to beat you, Rock. I need it more than anything that you can ever imagine.
When you headline an event, you know, you've got to be on top of your game, be in the best of your game to put on a show and to warrant that main event status.
Austin was going to do everything he could to guarantee the nearly 68,000 attending in his home state of Texas would not be disappointed. The People's Champ had other ideas. He had worked hard while Austin was out to establish himself as the man in WWE. And the opportunity to prove his status with this WrestleMania rematch had the Brahma Bull almost bursting at the seams. If anything was for sure, it was that The Rock would do one thing, and one thing only.
Just bring it!
He'd been through the battles, he'd come into his own, nothing was handed to him, he earned it all, and he turned himself into the most electrifying man in sports entertainment. At no point in time in wrestling history were two stars, two wrestlers, as hot as both I was and The Rock was. It's hard to explain why we're such good opponents. We just were.
So now it's time for you to head into one of the biggest WrestleManias of all time, WrestleMania 17 in 2001, a night that serves as the pinnacle of the Attitude Era's excellence, with its two biggest names doing battle once again. Are you ready to open up a can on The Rock? Or will you find out that going one-on-one with the Great One isn't the electrifying opportunity it appears to be? Before the bell could even make this match official, the action was underway. Austin was proving that he'd do anything to win, first attacking Rock while his back was turned, and then looking to use the WWE Championship. Rock had a brief moment where he unloaded some of his trademark rights, but then ran into Austin's Thez Press. Austin was wrestling with a hint of desperation not usually seen from him. A very, very fast start for Austin, as he'd use a couple of his running elbows to rattle Rocky in the early moments. Was The Rock not ready for Austin's tactics? Would he be able to get back into the match quickly before Austin really started stomping a mud hole?
Thank you.
Once the action went to the ringside area, the brutality really got ratcheted up. Rock used the announce table and timekeeper's table to his advantage. But took his eye off Austin for one brief moment, which allowed Austin the chance to clock him with the belt. Austin was really looking like a different superstar than the one we'd known the last few years. There was a sinister look in his eye as he yelled at officials. A more deliberate approach as he threw heavy rights at The Rock, who stumbled all over trying to stay on his feet. Austin's face wore an angry sneer while he planned his next move, knowing he had plenty of time with Rocky hurt. Back in the ring, Austin continued a methodical, brutal beatdown to the People's Champion. Right after right after right, despite the objections of the referee, found their mark. Thank you. Even when Rock was able to land a few strikes of his own, Austin immediately cut off his offensive surge. Stone Cold hadn't been WWE champion for nearly 18 months, and it was clear that this had done something to his psyche. The Rock wasn't the reason that Austin was out, but he had clearly benefited the most from Austin's absence. And it seemed that Austin was taking every opportunity to make Rock pay for taking what he considered to be his. Did The Rock really underestimate what kind of match this was going to be? Had he considered Austin to be a friend? Did he not take Austin's words at face value? For a little bit there, it looked like Austin had completely overwhelmed The Rock. But The Rock never lost faith in himself. He took advantage of Austin backing off and clotheslined his way back into the match. Once he had Austin down, Rock was able to reevaluate the situation. And once he went to ringside to grab the timekeeper's bell. Instant karma, it seemed, was going to get Austin. Now it was The Rock who was going to find an angrier, meaner place inside. And it was The Rock who was going to make Stone Cold Steve Austin suffer. With no rules to hold them back, the Brahma Bull and the Rattlesnake were going to throw absolutely everything at each other with the dream of leaving WrestleMania 17 as WWE champion. Back and forth they'd gone, but neither Austin nor The Rock had found that moment that would give them the win. As Austin attempted an Irish whip, though, The Rock would surprise him with a stone cold stunner of his own. The millions and millions of Rock's fans exploded. Would this be it? Could The Rock embarrass Austin like this by beating him with his own move in Texas? Austin would display his hallmark grit, managing to kick out at the two count. And while the two men laid on the mat, trying to find the spark to get back to their feet, Mr. McMahon would make his entrance. All eyes are on Mr. McMahon, but in the ring, Austin flattens The Rock with an incredible spine buster, which gets a two count. Caught up in his frustration, Austin blindly rushes at Rock, who now flattens Austin with his spine buster. That leads to the people's elbow. But when Rock covers Austin, Mr. McMahon breaks up the pin. That's right, Mr. McMahon helped Stone Cold Steve Austin. To this day, I cannot believe I ever saw that happen. The look on The Rock's face is pretty much the look that I had. What the hell? Rock's anger raged over, and he made a huge mistake in forgetting about Austin in hopes of laying the smackdown on Mr. McMahon, which led to him running straight into a Stone Cold version of the Rock Bottom. Mr. McMahon had turned the match on its head, and Stone Cold Steve Austin looked ready to strike and finish his quest of regaining the WWE Championship under some unthinkable circumstances. It was inevitable. Stone Cold was going to win, and it was obvious to everyone watching. The Rock had been able to get back into it once Mr. McMahon had arrived. Now Stone Cold was obliterating The Rock with a chair as Mr. McMahon instructed him, and all we could do was watch. Somewhere in the darkest places of Steve Austin's mind, he had convinced himself that the only way to get back to where he was would be by teaming with the man who had been his biggest enemy for years. Had the man never really changed? Had he simply fooled the fans during those years where he was WWE's most popular superstar?
Here's your winner.
Should it have ever been surprising that the man who preached DTA, don't trust anybody, was not someone to be trusted? Or had something changed in Austin while he was gone? And how could The Rock have ever expected anything like this to happen?